I'm Vijay Bhavaraju from Eaton Corporation. I work in the Innovation Center in Wisconsin. I'm a powertronics basic background, and I also have a lot of power conversion as well as microgrids is my current focus. So hardware in the loop and doing microgrids. We started about a couple of years ago looking at hardware in the loop systems and trying to understand how we can do a lot of the work without putting the real big inverters and big generators in the lab. This symposium is actually giving us an opportunity to mingle with other vendors who are doing the same type of work. For example, working with Typhoon's hardware in the loop. We are trying to understand the hardware in the loop system, how to use it, what are the benefits, how do we need to make sure that our controller can be tested out. So one of the things that we always look at is that the controller can be tested with a neutral environment and certified. And we are part of the IEEE 2030.7 and .8 to do this kind of work. I've been working with hardware in the loop for the last 20 years close to. There's a huge difference between what we were working at that time to now. One of the things that is really important nowadays is that you can do a lot of modeling with much higher fidelity to understand the behavior of things that are move much faster, like inverter-based converters and system like that. So it is very important in all our development to do a hardware in the loop. And we are trying to figure out what type of hardware in the loop is required for what type of application. For example, when we are looking at silicon carbide type of inverters, we are looking for someone who can do nanosecond type of time steps. So those are things definitely we are trying to understand, and this kind of conference allows us to figure out where each of the hardware loop suppliers are in this area. The microgrids is is still in development to a large extent. There are many requirements coming from the customer end, and we cannot define a particular microgrid and say this is what is we can offer. So what happens is we need to have a flexible architecture. The hardware in the loop really helps us in doing that because we model to a customer's requirement. So a PV and energy storage customer, we do the PV and energy storage. If there's another customer who wants to include a generator, and not a diesel but a natural gas, then we model that part of it. So that way we are really expanding the capability of the microgrid controller within a hardware in the loop system, instead of trying to pre-design and guess some of the work. We have divided our approach to have a local controller for the device level and a system controller for the supervisory level control. A local controller, we could actually make it work with a PV, like the EPC inverter, or we could make it work with the Woodward converter first before we could actually put it integrated into as a system. So this kind of a hierarchical structure, and then able to make it easy for the installation, commissioning, and operation is what our key experience told us. I mean, our experience has been that it's a lot of effort to configure everything in the field, and that's why we brought hardware in the loop systems and our architecture so that we can do a lot of pre-configuration and pre-engineering. We are getting to a point where we will be doing much larger systems, so they have to figure out how to concentrate on the fidelity at certain areas and less fidelity in the other areas. So it's going to be a compromise on how we manage this system. We're getting there.